today I am announcing my candidacy for the nomination of my Republican Party to serve as your President of the United States.
In case you missed it, the fireworks weren't just going off in the air over the weekend. Another contender announced his bid for the presidency, but can Michigan Congressman Thaddeus McCotter distinguish himself amongst an already crowded GOP field? Well, let's find out, because he's my guest right now. Good morning to you, Congressman.
Good morning, Gretchen. Thanks for having me on.
I thought you were going to show up with your guitar.
Well, it's a little early. The guys in the crew here would go deaf.
Well, I want to get to that in a minute, because that's really an interesting quality about you that does make you stand out in the GOP field. But how do your policies make you stand out? What are you going to bring to the table that's different than what we've heard already?
I think a comprehensive view of the challenges facing the country that'll be generational, including the restructuring of government, the restructuring of the Wall Street banks to get credit flowing so the economy can get moving. The People's Republic of Communist China is a strategic threat rival model of governance. More of an emphasis on how we're going to deal with the Iranian regime trying to implode it beneath its people's aspirations for freedom. And as we've heard, how to prevent the federal bureaucracy or the imperial judiciary from trying to enforce its views on families and communities that are trying to continue to impart their own moral teachings to their children and amongst themselves.
Mm-hmm. I know you have a new book out called Seize Freedom, so people can check that out to learn more about you as well. We've been doing this lightning round sort of thing with some of the candidates who have announced that they want to become president. So if you would oblige me to ask you some of the similar questions that we've asked others. I want to start with the debt ceiling and the debt limit. Of course, that's top of mind this week as the president's going to meet now again with members of Congress. So in your mind, should we raise the debt limit cleanly, or should there be strings attached?
Cut, cap, and balance.
So you would, do you agree with most of the GOP candidates then?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So we're going to be really lightning on this. All right.
Bank bailout. Well, you said lightning.
Here I go. A bank bailout or not?
No.
No. Auto bailout or not?
Yes.
Now, I know you disagree with Governor Romney on that. You're both from the state of Michigan, where the car business is huge. Why do you think the bailout was a good idea?
Well, I disagree with the Wall Street bailout, not only because it failed, but because it was unjust redistribution of wealth up. When you have that situation, you cannot allow America's manufacturing base to decline and go down. We have to be a nation that produces, that farms, that manufactures. If not, then we're going to simply be another mall in the age of globalization.
Another huge issue on the minds of voters is health care. So, do you like Obamacare or Massachusetts care, federal versus state?
Well, I don't like either one, because both mass care and Obamacare were based on the concept of comparative effectiveness research, which is very inhumane and allows a government bureaucrat to determine whether you get treatment or not as to its bang for the buck and your quality of life years as they determine. I think it should be patient-centered wellness, supply-side reforms put in place so that the supply of health care can grow to meet the demand.
All right, let's say that you get the nomination and you only have two choices to pick for vice president. They happen to be Michelle Bachmann, the congresswoman from Minnesota, or the former governor of Alaska, Sarah Palin. Who'd be your choice?
Well, I'm not going to presume the nomination, and I also am smart enough not to jump into the middle of that.
Okay, so you like them both, I guess. And finally, who's your favorite guitarist? And this is a special question just for you, because I don't think we asked a huntsman this question. Since you play the guitar, who's your favorite?
Well, Huntsman's a keyboard player, so he needs to use one hand, you know. Hendrix is the best guitar player ever, but I like listening to Keith Richards. I like Pete Townsend. I like George Harrison.
All right. Well, that part of it humanizes you so much when you get up there on stage and whip out the guitar. So glad to showcase you for our viewers today, Congressman from Michigan, Thaddeus McCotter. Great to see you.